Piet Mondrian was a Dutch artist known for his abstract art. He liked using line, shape, and usually the primary colors, red, yellow, and blue, to create his paintings. Today we're going to make an animal inspired by Mondrian's work. For this project, you'll need some thicker paper. I have watercolor paper. We'll be using a ruler, pencil and sharpie, and I have some animal pictures. I just went online and I typed in different animals' outlines, and then I printed a bunch of different ones off. I was looking for just basic outline shapes that didn't include a lot of details on the inside of the animal. Pick an animal that you like to use for this project, or you can do the whale along with me. I'll also be using some construction paper later, some watercolor paints, and some scissors. I'm going to start off by putting my paper the same direction as my animal. Since my whale is horizontal, I want my paper to be horizontal as well. I'm going to have my picture close by so that I can look at it while I'm drawing. I'm going to start off by drawing with a pencil, just in case I need to erase. I want my picture to take up as much of my paper as possible. So instead of just starting and drawing right away, I'm going to make some marks to show where I want the front of the whale to be. I'm also going to look and see where I want the back of the whale to be. I'm going to do the bottom line of the whale and the top of the whale. I do this before drawing just to make sure that my picture is nice and big and fills up the entire space of my paper. Now I can kind of connect my marks so that I can make the outline of the whale. I'm trying to draw lightly with my pencil right now. You can see I'm hardly touching, and that way, if I make a mistake, it's easier to erase. At this point too, if there's something that I want to change with my animal picture, I can always change it. It doesn't have to look exactly like the picture that I'm looking at. I'm also going to show where the eye is on the whale, and I'm going to add a fin. I'm going to make mine just a little bit longer than the one in the picture. Now I'm going to use my Sharpie. I'm using a fatter Sharpie as opposed to those really skinny ones. And I want to make a line that goes around the outside of my whale. Sometimes it's easier to turn the paper to get the right angle of the line. I'm trying to make a nice smooth outline with my Sharpie, and I'm turning my paper as I go until I get the entire picture outlined with my black Sharpie. I'm trying to be very careful in this point to make sure my lines are nice and smooth. I'm also going to add the eye by outlining it, and then I'm going to color it in as well. When I color it in, I'm going to leave a little part of it white to look like a little highlight in the eye. The rest of it I color in black. I don't need my little picture anymore. Now I need my ruler and my pencil. When using my ruler, I'm going to start with vertical lines. Vertical lines, again, are the ones that go up and down. Notice on the hand that I'm using to hold my ruler, I have my fingers spread wide out so that my ruler doesn't move. I'm adding lines in different thicknesses all the way down my whale. I'm not staying in the lines because we will be cutting this out later. Some lines are closer together, some lines are farther apart, until I have all of my whale filled with lines. I would suggest maybe 8 to 10 lines. Try not to go more than that. Next, I'm going to add horizontal lines. Remember, horizontal lines are the ones that go from side to side. Again, I'm going to try to spread my fingers out on my ruler so that it doesn't move when I'm drawing my lines. Now that I have the lines on my whale, I'm going to use my Sharpie to trace over them. I'm trying to be careful to make sure that my lines are still straight. I'm adding my last couple lines now to my picture, and I'm happy with how it's looking. I'm going to put my Sharpie away for now. I will get it out later again. And now I'm going to switch to painting. I'm using watercolor paints and a flat brush. That'll make it easier to make straight lines. I've got my water cup ready, and I'm starting off with my red. Now, I did speed up my video a little bit, just to kind of help get through the video a little bit faster here. You can see that as I am painting with my red, I'm kind of jumping around to different shapes on my whale. If you want to, you can have some of them right next to each other, but I chose to have none of my red ones touching each other. So I'm going around my picture. I'm using not a lot of water, but more paint so that it's nice and bright colored, and I'm filling in different shapes with my red paint. As I'm doing this, I'm trying to be very careful with my edges to make sure that I'm staying inside of my lines. I want this to look nice and neat. You can see how the flat brush helps with making those lines nice and straight. If I do happen to go out of a line, you can always just use your finger or a Kleenex or something like that to blot out the color. Now that I have my red, I'm going to add some more colors. Next on my list, yellow. Yellow is also a primary color, and I'm going to go ahead and fill in some of the other shapes with yellow. Now, it's important when you're filling in some colors to make sure that you leave some of the shapes white. Mondrian liked to have a lot of white shapes in his picture too. And if we add all of the colors too much, we'll run out of white spots. I'm also going to have some in black later, so I'm trying to make sure that I don't do too many yellow, too many red, so that I leave room for some of the other colors. Next up is blue. Blue is the third primary color and is also another one that Mondrian liked to use in his art. I'm adding blue to some of the open spaces, again trying not to have any of the blues touch each other side by side, but you can have them touch side by side if you prefer. I do want to remember to leave some open for white and black. You can always start off with just a few of each color and then go back and add more after you have some of all of the colors in your picture. You can see that I've added a couple more things to my whale. I added some black spots and a couple extra lines just for fun. Now that I have everything on my whale, I want to cut it out. So I'm taking my scissors and trying to be very careful in cutting on the lines of my whale. Now that I have my whale cut out, I decided to put it on a background. I could do a big background like this and maybe even add a fun border, but for now, I'm just gonna put it on a little background. This is red construction paper and I could glue it like that. And there you have it, my final whale inspired by Mondrian. Hope you enjoyed and thanks for watching.